How did you, where were you born and where, you know, how was your childhood?
I was born in Baltimore, Maryland, on the East Coast. It was on the Civil Wars. It was on the South Side in the Civil War. It was a segregated city when I grew up. There, it was the sixth largest city in the United States, so it was a big population. We only had three high schools for so-called black students. Mm-hmm. Two on the west side, one on the east side.
The head teachers were black. The teachers were also the main teachers.
It was segregated. Oh, right. It was totally segregated. Right. Yeah, it was like Mississippi, but because Maryland, named after Queen Mary.
Yeah.
Was considered free, you know, base. You know, when you get the base, okay, everything's good. They didn't want, when dignitaries came over to the area, they didn't want them to see slavery. Wow. They didn't want them to, so even though they had segregation and on the Eastern Shore they had slaves,
yeah,
you know, so-called slaves. And because I don't call them slaves.
Yeah, they were prisoners of war, weren't they, really?
Well, yeah, absolutely, yeah. And I mean, the country had indentured servants, you know, so that was already, and even so-called blacks were indentured, you know, so they'd work off their thing and go away. But when they started bringing the Africans, citizens over here, of course, they didn't speak the language, and they didn't know any better.
Yeah.
So what happened was that they would live, have kids, and the kids were born into slavery.
Mm-hmm.
No other, I don't know of any other enslavement, any other country or group of people who enslaved people, and their kids were slaves forever. You'd be a slave.
Mm.
This was new,
you know.
And so that's where I came from.
Yeah. And how did your parents, how did they feel about that? Or did they, you know, how did they get along?
Well, they knew who they were.
Yeah.
They knew who they were, you know, as much as they could, you know, as much as they could. You know, it wasn't until I moved to New York and was around people like Max Roach and Charles Dominguez and, you know, people like that, that I really began to learn real history, you know, where we came from. Because he had a book, he had a little pamphlet called 100 Amazing Facts About the Negro, written by J.A. Rogers.
J.A. Rogers is a very well known.
Oh, yeah. And the book was so fascinating. I mean, Beethoven was black, you know, Queen Sophia of England was black. I mean, you know, and so now, that means it was deliberate.
Yeah.
That means everything they did was deliberate, you know, because they know, they knew.
Yeah, J.A. Rogers is very well known. He did, I've forgotten the name of the book, it was about color.
Sex, he did that, but I think his big, most important work was Sex and Race.
Yeah, Sex and Race was another one.
Yeah, because that's three volumes of that, and it's about miscegenation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He kind of,
I mean, it's just, I mean, things like when you see so-called white people and their name is black.
Yeah.
that's not a coincidence normally. That's not a coincidence, yeah. You know. And, you know, he's got one pamphlet called The Five Black Presidents.
Before George Washington?
After. Five Black Presidents.
There was some before him as well.
Yeah, I know. Well, the first president, you know, right. Was, you know, because it wasn't called president then. No. You know, but the five Black Presidents, and he's shown Warren Harding, which was one of them. Warren Harding, and it was showing how the family split off, and the dark side became Hardings, and the white side became Hardings.
Yeah.
So now they're the same family, but the darker one, you know, I mean, and that happened so throughout the world. Mm-hmm. I mean, the race, look, I mean, I get so tired of this, but there's only one human race on
That's
Earth,
right, yeah.
You know, and for everybody, even intelligent people to say, well, yeah, we're two black men, you know, no, they were two humans,
right.
two male humans.
Yeah.
And now if you want to start describing them, say, well, they had dark skin and, you know, they were chocolate, but they were two humans.
First.
They were not black men.
Yeah, first.
That's not a race.
No, it's not.
And I get so sick of hearing everybody say that.
Yeah.
You know?
But that's a game. That's a divisive thing.
Absolutely it is. They tricked us. They tricked everybody.
Right.
You know?
Right. It's amazing. Because I think we're coming to the end of that, because the younger generation is starting to learn some of these things which we didn't learn so early on. I mean, you know, J.A. Rogers, for example, there aren't too many people that know about him.
Because he knew what the publishers wouldn't touch that book.
No, of course not.
He had to put it out himself.
Right.
You know, I went up to, once I saw that book at Max's, I said, where'd you get this?
It was Max Roach's book.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He told me he got it up at Michaud's bookstore.
Yeah.
On 125th and 7th Avenue, I think.
Yeah.
And so I went up there, and he had all his books.
Mm.
And to my surprise, because he had his office, Michaud had his office in the back. First of all, he'd have books open and underlined things for you to read. You know, I mean, it was really an educational store.
Yeah.
But not to mention, he had all the so-called black books. And but I look in the back in his office, and he's back there talking to Malcolm X.
Whoa.
That's the first time I saw Malcolm.
Really?
Yeah. And
that's amazing.
Yeah, so I used to go up there all the time, you know. And then we used to go to eat at Shabazz, the restaurant, you know. And we ate at that one on 116th Street, because we knew Malcolm came in about 5 or 6 every day after, because he worked at Muhammad Speaks, the newspaper, when he would come down and have something to eat.
Yeah.
And we would just follow him, just go along.
Because
he'd walk through the neighborhood and talk to everybody, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, he was the most, he was really loved.
Really hospitable guy, wasn't he?
He was, the two people I've been around that had a so-called Christ-like or Buddha-like effect around me anyway. And that was Malcolm and John Coltrane, both of them.
John Coltrane, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Exactly.
Very spiritual.
I mean, you just felt it. There was an aura, just a goodness.
Yeah.
A goodness.
His achievements are enormous.
And they can't have that. They have to kill everybody that has that aura.
That, of course, yeah. That's right. They have to be got rid of.
Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I didn't know that you had met Malcolm. I didn't know that. No. You must have met because that's quite a story, how they've shown recently even that it was two of our own people, two men of the community.
They're not sure. However, if it was, it didn't start with them.
No. I think the problem that we have is that we think that the people who have done all the terrible things look like her.
Mm-hmm.
In actual fact, they look like us.
Mm-hmm.
They are the bosses. Because our planet is run by people with very old money.
Mm-hmm.
Who's the oldest here? Mm-hmm. They look like us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They're paying these people to do these things.
Mm-hmm.
He who has the gold makes the rules.
Mm-hmm.
That's the golden rule.
Yeah.
had the same problems that you have in Jamaica. Marcus Garvey came from Jamaica.
Oh, I know.
To help you guys.
Yes.
So why was that? Because these people knew what was going on. Mm-hmm. So they had to come together to break it, this thing down.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They had to come together because they said, hey, we're in trouble here. We're being wiped out.
Yeah.
People, our parents were weren't that stupid. I know my mother was she had a beautiful handwriting.
None of our ancestors.
She was too educated for that to be.
They got us this far.
Right. Yeah. So, do you really think these people are going to let some of these more backward cultures just walk in? No, it doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that.
No, you're right.
And that's how they've tricked us.
Yeah. Well, they've tricked everybody. Tricked themselves. Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Because now it's over.
Yeah,
I think now it's over.
I think what's over is the species. We're over.
No.
The planet is going to be here. Fine. Yeah. We're destroying the planet. It's just like in some neighborhoods, they say, well, you know, they come in and they ruin the neighborhoods. Mm. The house that they live in, they actually ruin. That's what we're doing.
Mm.
We live on this planet, but we're ruining it. We are ruining this.
Yeah,
planet.
But if you think about it, I mean, I see myself as very fortunate. I don't know how you see yourself, but I've had to shoot my own shoe shop. These are my shoe designs. Mm-hmm. I'm one of the few people of my tan that have been able to do that because most people are not allowed. They don't allow you, as we've spoken. They don't allow you. Mm-hmm. Those people, they're saying, destroying the neighborhood. Because they got nothing else to do.
Absolutely. I know why it happens. Yeah. But I'm saying, on the larger scale, we're doing that. And whoever.
They're encouraging
that. And it's mostly.
But
why would they want to do that?
Because they are different from us. They're not quite the same as us.
Well, that's a whole other thing.
They're not quite the same as us. They look like us.
That's a whole other thing.
That's right.
So you read David Icke?
I know all of the stuff.
I do too.
Phil Valentine.
No, I'm not familiar with it.
Black, he's one of us.
It's like that. Yeah.
No, about metaphysics and everything.
Oh, yeah.
Our
yeah.
history, our true history.
Mm-hmm.
Bobby Hemmett, people like that.
Mm-hmm.
What's the other gentleman's name from the. You must know him. He's a good friend with Malcolm also. He was explaining our history.
Dr. Ben.
Dr. Ben, of course. Yeah. Dr. Ben. Mm-hmm. So I know all these. Yeah, I know what they were.
Mm-hmm.
I know their work.
Yeah.
And I've lived in the other countries to see that they're doing the same thing.
But they could only segregate. Before it was class. Here it seems more like
it's
class.
It's more mixed. People are more mixed now. Have you seen how many mixed children you have?
Everywhere.
Right. So something.
But it's always been like that. Because because when you have a war and you send the soldiers.
They're going to have children.
Yes.
Right.
Always. Right. And that's been going on forever.
Right.
You know, so that if unless there's a tribe somewhere that nobody's ever seen.
Yeah.
They're
going to be mixed.
Everybody's mixed.
So what does that tell you? It means that they couldn't win. Whoever is planning what they planned, they couldn't win. Because people are always going to be mixed.
But they're still trying to do
They're still trying, yes, but they're not going to win.
I know they're not going to win, but they don't care.
And I think that, no, because they've got, if people have good things in their heart, they will focus on doing good things.
Well, yeah, you know, like if they're John human, but that's why I'm saying I call it being human.
Like Malcolm or these guys, they wouldn't be doing those kind of things. They couldn't do it.
Yeah.
It's not in their nature. Mm. But these people, that's what they have in their nature.
Yeah.
That's why they're doing it to the end.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
The same as you playing your instrument.
Yeah.
You're going to do it to the end.
Yeah.
No, and that's, and when you look at it like that, you can understand, okay, these are poor creatures.
Yeah. That's at Babe Ruth. I don't know
his name. Babe Ruth, of course.
Babe Ruth has
the baseball player.
Yeah. Yeah. He says, it's hard to beat a man that won't give up.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Look at boxing.
Yeah.
How many people boxing has destroyed to the end, to the point that they cannot even speak properly.
Yeah.
They've gone right over the line.
Yeah. Although nowadays they're beginning to, they're a little smarter.
Yeah.
The reason why that happened was because it's the same thing in the music industry.
Yeah.
They didn't know anything about laws, contracts. They signed things away. People owned them.
Yeah.
And we're just going through. I don't know whether you've seen the Hargrove movie.
Which one?
Roy Hargrove.
Oh, no, I didn't. I know he died, but I didn't see the film yet.
Yeah, they're showing. And his situation was that when he was a teenager, his mother gave parental guidance over to his manager.
Oh, really?
And so for the rest of his career, he didn't own himself.
Yeah.
You know, so, but that same thing, like with Joe Louis. Yeah. Joe Louis got in tax, probably. They could have, you know, I mean, he owed so much money, which would, he had given more money during the war, because he gave some of his purses to the war effort during the war, you know. And they wanted to tax that. They, you know, they know how to get you because they own laws. If you make a law, you know, there was a law that decided you could keep a so-called slave in perpetuity.
Yeah.
They went to court.
Yeah.
They went to court about that.
Yeah.
Because that was, well, you know, because once they started realizing, well, you know, well, there's indentured, there's different, different servants, different slave, you know, categories.
Well, that all began because the people who look like us who are in Europe, you know, those, many of those kings, like J.A. Rogers said, they look like us.
Yeah. Yeah.
So these people from there, because they had come through the, they were kicked out of Africa, went to places like Greece and Italy, made those empires there, went to, also part of them went to Spain, the Moors. Remember, they remember that they conquered there?
Absolutely.
Right. So now these same people,
you can see it once you go
there.
That's
right. You can see it right on them. But these people, especially the Romans, look how many slaves they had. All those people, they brought them to America.
Yeah.
That's what they did.
Yeah,
that's it was those people.
Yeah.
And that mentality, they brought that mentality with them. You didn't have it before in the States.
Yeah.
You didn't have slaves then.
Yeah.
Didn't exist.
Well, no, I mean, they came and tried to wipe out, they genocide on the Native Americans.
Yes.
That
lived there. Yeah.
You know, and they thought they had come in peace. I mean, there were people there when Columbus, and Columbus knew where he was going. There was a navigator, and he was an African. Yeah, he was a Moor.
He was a Moor.
And he was the navigator. Right. They knew where they were going.
Petro Negro, something like that. Mm-hmm. It means Peter the Black.
Yeah.
Or Peter the Negro. Yeah, Peter the Black, right. So that tells, I mean, that's what I'm saying, it's our own people that's been doing it.
Yeah.
And they've been pushing
these. See, but this is history that we need, that...
That's why they're not going to do it. They're not going to let it.
No, because what would happen?
They're finished.
They're over.
They're finished. They're over.
Yeah. But that's why they keep their guns.
Right.